Russia, U.S. to resist eliminating smallpox strains. Global Security Newswire, January 18, 2011. The United States and Russia are expected to argue to the international community this week that bioterrorism fears justify their continued retention of smallpox strains for countermeasure research purposes. Envoys from 34 member governments to the World Health Organization, including Moscow and Washington, are slated tomorrow to debate whether adequate study has been conducted on producing smallpox countermeasures so that a cutoff date could be established for eliminating the Russian and U.S. strains. Washington has said it must retain its smallpox samples to prepare new medical treatments and vaccines that would be used in the event of a biological weapon strike or an unintended release of the deadly virus from a third party. Moscow also thinks its smallpox cache must be retained for study and is anticipated to agree with Washington's argument on the matter. Foreign states and public health specialists, however, worry that U.S. and Russian smallpox stocks could be misappropriated or accidentally released. Hundreds of millions of people are thought to have died following exposure to the virus, approximately one-third of the total number contaminated. A worldwide public health effort resulted in smallpox officially being eliminated from nature in 1980. The debate over eliminating the last known smallpox stocks has been highly contentious. Some argue the virus could be created in a laboratory using synthetic biology technology, leaving complete elimination unachievable. The possibly makes it even more important to destroy the Russian and U.S. stockpiles. The U.S. Centers for Disease and Control and Prevention today stores 451 specimens of the smallpox virus, while Russia keeps 120 different strains at its vector laboratory in Siberia. Boy, to put it bluntly, it is the same logic by which the superpowers continue the possession of the nuclear weapons. They wish to hold on to the smallpox virus as a super bioweapon. Of course they do. That and many other things. How to prepare for a terrorist attack. Homeland, 2011. Choose an out-of-town contact your family or household will call or email to check on each other should a disaster occur. Your selected contact should live far enough away that they would be unlikely to be directly affected by the same event, and they should know they are the chosen contact. Having a predetermined meeting place away from your home will save time and minimize confusion should your home be affected or the area evacuated. You need to know if they will keep children at school until a parent or designated adult can pick them up or send them home on their own. Be sure that the school has updated information about how to reach parents and responsible caregivers to arrange for a pickup. If disaster strikes, remain calm and be patient. Follow the advice of local emergency officials. Listen to your radio or television for news and instructions. Give first aid and get help for seriously injured people. Wear long sleeve shirts, long pants, and sturdy shoes so you can be protected as much as possible. Go to an interior room without windows that's above ground level. In the case of a chemical threat, an above ground location is preferable because some chemicals are heavier than air and may seep into basements even if the windows are closed. Using duct tape, seal all cracks around the door and any vents into the room. Many people may have come into contact with biological or chemical agent may need to go through a decontamination procedure and receive medical attention. NATO panel urges nations to eradicate all chemical arms. October 11th, 2011. Global Security Newswire. A key NATO panel on Sunday approved a draft text that urges Iraq, Russia, and the United States to eradicate their chemical warfare materials in a safe and secure manner. The NATO Parliamentary Assembly Science and Technology Committee in Bucharest dismissed an effort by Russia to substitute the call for the three nations to complete chemical demilitarization operations in due time with the word soon. Russia and the United States have announced they do not expect to meet an extended deadline of April 2012 set by the Chemical Weapons Convention to completely destroy their chemical weapons. Iraq also has a small cache of Saddam Hussein-era chemical weapons that has yet to begin eliminating. The NATO panel chose to keep its original wording on the thinking that Russia and the United States, as the holders of the world's two largest chemical arsenals, should act as positive role models to other nations in the elimination of their stockpiles. We are running late, and we need to give an example. We need to act seriously. The resolution additionally urges all nations to notify the international community of any secret arsenals of biological and chemical warfare agents and to halt such military efforts. The committee also pressed NATO members to implement steps to thwart potential biological and chemical terrorist strikes. Terrorists have largely failed to weaponize biological and chemical agents. Nevertheless, measures to counter biological and chemical threats still have to cope with numerous issues to become truly effective tools of arms control, disarmament, and non-proliferation.